Boy Red Grant Live, man, you know, coming into, just got into Atlanta, man, 6:30 a.m. flight. It's like 7, 8 o'clock, man. We doing it real big, man. I'm happy right now to be involved with this whole Shaquille O'Neal project.
Oh, yeah, the vibe is crazy, man. It's like the driver. This nigga crunk. Everybody turned up. Everybody turned up. Everybody jitting, just jitting. Just jitting. There you go. There you go. There you go. There you go. That's Atlanta. There you go.
Welcome to Atlanta, my brother.
Thank you. I appreciate that. It took a little doing getting here.
Yeah. You know, for me, it's different. It's my homecoming.
Yeah.
Because I haven't played Atlanta in a long time.
How'd you get here?
Well, you know, talking about physically?
Yeah.
I flew.
I think Atlanta's a great spot for an up-and-coming comedian. Like, the main thing you need as a comedian is stage time. Like, that's your number one. I mean, that's your biggest exercise is stage time, using that stage. That's what you need. And the more you on stage, the better you become.
I don't want to stay downtown. Well, it's going to be so many. It's going to be crazy down there. Strippers. Yeah, maybe I need to stay down there. Yeah. Y'all want to stop? Can we stop by the Magic City real quick?
I knew I was fat. Yeah. See, now you niggas is, I knew I was fat, but see, you know what? In America right now, y'all attacking the fat man. All these commercials about slim trim and all this bitch go to the motherfucking gym. I go to the gym, these motherfuckers won't let me in. These motherfuckers talking about this too late. I go to Jenny Craig, the bitch give me all the food, I ate all the food right there. She said, no, you supposed to last all week, the bitch, this ain't gonna last all week. They had pies and shit.
God damn it. They still got me sharing a room with Lavar, which I don't mind, don't get me wrong, but he likes to get dressed and walk around naked and shit. What the fuck is my agent?
What? Some of this Finesse Mitchell's on the mic, that's what I say. We in the ATL, that's every day. And then we about to do this shit the way that only we can do it, because we that cowboy.
Hey. Look at that, all the light-skinned niggas cowboy.
We got a lot of dark-skinned niggas in our love, too.
Yeah,
sure. Right. You know, you could be there, you know. Yeah. We're taking applications at all times.
You know y'all went out in the 80s, though, right?
Nah, we back, homie.
Y'all back.
You ain't seen the new videos out?
Who?
You ain't seen the new videos that's out?
Nah, all light skin, homie.
Hey, let me show y'all.
You ain't never heard of
Chris Brown? We get them, too. That's all you need. That's all you need to see, nigga. You know? We get some too.
Why even entertaining somebody dark skin with braces? Why are we doing that?
Yeah, that's light skin thing. That's a light skin thing. Braces, you supposed to have your teeth messed up.
Yeah. All girls care if you got straight teeth. You dark skin. They not with you for your teeth. It's because you dark. I don't know. You got to school some of these
kids. I'm going out there just like this.
That's what
nobody knows.
Yeah, rebellion.
The queen would be so happy.
Representing. I made this.
Two chains. Please show my wife your super chain right here.
Yo. Yo, move, Tiggs. I want this on camera. I'm about to kick Shaq's ass. Real talk. Put this on camera. Big.
What stool you about to get on?
I'm about to do shit looking like a motherfucking mortician.
You ain't talking about that. You look like a big ass pallbearer. Mortician, nigga. He the only pallbearer, too. You carry the whole motherfucking cast like a briefcase. You be walking that bitch out. You walk this bitch out the church. Nigga, the professional pallbearer.
I'm wide. I got everybody.
Like a briefcase, nigga.
Okay, sorry.
Russell came from music and did the comedy jam. Shaq came from sports.
I never looked at it.
Yeah, there's nobody coming from comedy in the entertainment business and doing comedy for black Americans. Mm. So it takes somebody like Russell and Shaq to go, hey, these guys are funny too. Why I gotta watch this corny ass white boy on TV every day? Mm-hmm. Let me, you know. And what's funny is Shaq has a, it's not just really a black brand. Everybody loves him. So then it gives, with Def Jam was kind of urban, this is kind of, it's like the all-stars.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, so everybody can enjoy it, not just black Americans, you know, Kevin Hart being, you know, Kevin Hart didn't really take off till everybody seen this. Mm-hmm. And it wasn't just, you see what I'm saying? Yeah, so it's like, and he been around, trust me. He was around bugging motherfuckers. Kevin, you was bugging motherfuckers with them jokes.
Y'all give up the shoulder with this goddamn cartoon beard he got drawn. If we get hot out in this bitch, that old beard gonna melt the fuck off and he gonna be like, God damn, it's hot.
Y'all give it up for Lavar looking like a 47-year-old, 13-year-old. Oh, I want to be young, nigga ass. Looking like somebody goddamn trying to be cool ass uncle. What a hoes, what a hoes.
Nigga, how long your teeth been fighting for position, motherfucker?
That's all right.
You look like a gang fight going on in your mouth.
It's all
like
good.
Your teeth are shooting.
That's the only thing look good on you. Look, Lavar like he dealing with stage 4 terminal cancer. He don't get the hell out.
Hey, I know this nigga ain't talking with all them wood grain ass teeth in his goddamn mouth. When did all your teeth die, nigga? You need to go.
Hey, man, Finesse Mitchell looking like the goddamn poster boy for H&M in this bitch.
And Shawty got Eddie Long tattooed on the back of his ass.
That's all right, Joe.
Def Comedy Jam was the pinnacle of black comedy. You know, it started it all, of black comedy. And, you know, Shaq kind of picked that movement up, which is good because I think black people and white people, I think comics just need a place to go where they can showcase their talents. And, you know, a lot of times, you know, people don't know who the next people are. You know, just like Kevin Hart, after he did Shaquille O'Neal All-Star, to me, he took off. You know, he just went to that other level. And it's a lot of people, as soon as they hit Shaq, from Gary Owens to D-Ray to Corey Holcomb, Mike Blackson, all them boys, man, once they did Shaq All-Star, they was getting big numbers at their shows. So Shaq not only is like putting people on and showing, you know, showcasing them, he helping them get that bread, that new bread.
There used to be this club in L.A. called Athletic Club, and that's right when he first got traded. So everybody was like, Shaq's in L.A., you know, everybody, Shaq's in L.A., yeah. So, and he would be around L.A., just be around L.A. So I pull up, I used to have me a little lower, you know, had a Monte Carlo MC, right, on them things. So I pull up and he was looking at my car. He pulled up with a Bentley with a fish tank in it. I was like, nigga, that's Trey. And we was cool ever since. He always at the comedy clubs, always been supportive. You know, he was just always down. He was just always down, always around. Back then, Chris Tucker and I used to be together every day. And this is right when Friday came out, or right before. I think it was right we were shooting or some shit. But he was always around and always down, you know. You know, some people get 35 hours and they start changing their whole, I must change my appearance. They do the Nene Leakes, you know. You swear she made $57 million last year. But Shaq always kept it 100.
Wait, how y'all doing, Atlanta? Good, good, good. Let me get this shit. They ain't give me that much time, so this shit gonna go real, real fast. I'm the new nigga. I've been in Atlanta for about 2 days. I've been fucking up since I got here. I'm ready to go. My first mistake was I went and ate at this Chinese buffet that they got around the corner from my room. It's good food at the buffet, too, if you don't mind shitting. If you don't mind shitting, then I recommend the Chinese buffet. It's right around the corner from the room. Because I had the shit at the Chinese buffet. I had the shit there. I was sitting there eating with my friend Smooth earlier. He was like, nigga, what's wrong with your face? I say, dude, I'm 2 centimeters dilated. I'm sitting in here shitting on myself in this Chinese. That goddamn Chinese food, y'all got real Chinese people cooking y'all food. We don't have that shit. I ate an egg roll, that shit was diabolical. That shit came right back. I ate that, I said, nigga, did I eat that or drop it? Let me get my ass up from here and go on to the back. I picked my plate up and walked off. The lady said, you need a to-go plate? I say, ma'am, I'm taking this to the commode. I gotta eat this shit in the bathroom. First time in my life, my shit stank to me. Normally, I could take my shit. It's other folks' shit I can't take. Second mistake I made, I went to the nice mall y'all got. Fantastic mall. Nice, whatever. I got hit on twice in the mall today. That's the good news. Problem was, both times it was by dudes. And I don't fuck around like that no more. I don't know what these Shaq people told y'all. I don't know what they told y'all about me on that damn internet. But me and Dunham McClurkin, we can change our lives.
Gina, are those your
black
shoes?
I don't think
your
rose was.
Nah, those mine.
I ain't got no shoes. Like, oh, shit, I told y'all that I don't do shoes. I do sneaks.
Those
yeah,
are sneaks, that's why I asked. I was like, oh, I thought it was black. She said, no, I do colorful sneaks.
Yeah. No, those mine.
I don't do shoes. I'm a skinny jean sneaks and a jacket kind of girl. That's me.
That's you.
That's me.
Okay.
I got y'all. See, guys. We working before we working. The fuck is this?
Huh? The fuck is this?
Gina
Yashere. Hey, that was pretty good. That was a pretty good amount. Did you hear that? That was quite good.
How I said it?
No, how I said it. I did an American thing. I did like your
I already know your accent is fake anyway. You're from Compton.
I'm from Compton, bitch. What? What, bitch? That was pretty good. I thought that was quite good. Oh my God. Really? Oh my God! See that's it. That's all I can say.
Just go to AliExpress.
I just went to the barbershop the other day.
And these are like thousands. Okay. Yeah. I was like.
Finesse Mitchell, Shaq All-Star Comedy Jam. That's usually how I do it. Two women at a time.
Menage a trois.
Tag team, baby.
Tag team. I wake up already, kind of perfect. But today I decided to let beautiful women. Work on this.
You know, the canvas.
It's not even a canvas.
Well, how many
I heard Gina say she was a canvas. I'm kind of already a masterpiece. You know what I mean? And I just need somebody to, like, you know, dust me.
Because Finesse Mitchell, since he was 9 years old, has been pretty flawless. Yeah.
Up until eight, I was kind of hideous. You know, they didn't know if I was boy or girl. But then my nut sack dropped when I was 9, and there it is.
Oh, we getting a beard now.
Yeah, you like that,
you see?
See?
That
thing, you said that thing came in like that? That's
shit.
How I do it. See, I told you.
You see that thing? You must have told it about that paycheck.
It's magic. It's magic.
Magically delicious.
And they do the close-ups on the show tonight, and the girls see the scruff coming in. They're going to be like, ooh, Maxwell.
Stop it.
I remember the owner of the Comedy Store, which is in Beverly Hills, Hollywood, coming down to South Central to see Robin Harris. Now, this bitch got in her car and drove South Central by herself, said, who's this funny motherfucker? It's never happened before. Because Robin wouldn't go. Back then, it was really segregated comedy. Like, they would call you, he does white rooms. He does the white rooms. Mm-hmm. He does the black rooms.
Right.
The chitlin circuit. I was kind of fortunate to do Boston. I'm just doing jokes. Fuck y'all niggas. Mm-hmm. You know? But you go to the comedy club, you better be funny. You go to Harlem, you know, Def Jam got started because of a little room in Harlem that we used to wait at for the Apollo on 125th and 5th Avenue. So it's a little room, no bigger than this room. And it was just a ruckus.
Hey, when you gonna take the candy wrap over there so we can eat the chocolate out there? Hey, that's that jewelry nigga when the man pulled out a little calculator on your ass. Hey, for you, my friend, I give it to you.
That's the name right now.
No, no, no.
Hey, y'all thought this nigga was sagging. He really built like that. That nigga's waist is really down here, nigga.
How you fuck a girl?
How that nigga fuck a bitch like that? You long torso body ass nigga. Hey, they invented the tall tee for this nigga. Those his waist is down here.
And they look like a fucking centaur.
You got no co-signer with you, man. Y'all fruity tooty booty ass out
of here, man. Did you get them glasses free with them cigarettes you bought?
What did they do at the gas station?
This high end.
That nigga got them glasses and that shirt. Oh, the nigga had a hey, nigga had a big stick. He got that bitch off the top rack. You get the shirt with the cigarettes.
This has been an amazing journey for me, you know, to go from damn near homeless 18 months ago to being on the, I just did a photo shoot for the cover of the Shaq All-Star DVD.
Yeah.
That if you wrote that down and like presented it to some film people, they'll say this shit is too far-fetched.
Can we talk about a strip club real quick?
Which one?
Let's go to the strip club. I gotta do some praying. Atlanta's a beautiful city.
It is.
Especially in them strip clubs.
My journey in comedy came early in life. You know, I was a 19-year-old kid. I had a full football scholarship at Savannah State University, and I lost it because my attitude problem. I had an attitude problem, and I lost my full football scholarship and got sent home. And when I got sent home, my frat brothers was like, "Rez, you need to do comedy. You can get on that Def Comedy Jam." And I was like, "F comedy and that Def Comedy Jam." And you know, 6 months later, I was on Def Comedy Jam. So I kind of started my career early, 19-year-old kid.
Man, people told me all my life I'd be a comedian. I never, you know, I'm from Chicago, I'm from the south side of Chicago. And you know, people would say that because I was just funny. You know, I was always clowning and shit in school. And the reason I guess I became funny at such a young age because my brother was born, I was five. When he was born, and I wasn't getting enough attention at home. So the first time I made this two little girls laugh, I put like some paper balls under my shirt and acted like a woman. You know, I was like first grade, you know, I had some titties and they laughed. I'm like, oh shit, I like this shit. So every day I was going to school doing something stupid to get any type of fucking attention, anything. Then I was a funny looking child, so you have to fight for attention when you're a crazy looking ass kid, you know.
So you said we can't stop by the strip club?
You wanna go right now? Let's make it happen.
Okay, cause
everybody in town waiting on you right now. It's all over social media.
Right, but the social media is at the strip club.
But to go from being almost homeless to being on the Shaq tour is like an amazing ride, thrill ride. It's like, it's kind of like I won American Idol.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I'm like a smarter, more handsome version of Fantasia.
I had to quickly start the process.
Oh, man. Live and living color. Your boy Red Grant, man. You know how we go. Going to that stage, man.
Aye! What do you want to get?
It's bigger than ever, baby. Shaq All Star, man, all day long. Shaq.com, at Shaq Comedy. Look, catch us all day, man. This is how we go. If you don't know how we go, now you know. Fresh to the stage. From fresh to no fresh to fresh. You know? In the Symphony Hall. Woo! Turn up all day.
On my way to the stage. Time to go to work. Time to put it down. It's like this shit like my, what is this shit like my Super Bowl today? First time taping. Showtime special. And it's gonna be great. It's gonna be major, baby. Shout out to the noobs, my noob and my frat brother Red Grant, my brother for the day.
Look, it's turned up time. I like you. You looking good, man. Looking good, man.
Looking quite that for yourself, bro.
Jokes ain't gonna change, though.
And I like that.
Don't go in there. I just done a poo. So, what do you want to know? I'm backstage at the Shaq All-Stars Comedy Jam. It's going to be awesome. I'm looking forward to it. I'm excited. This is very different from what I've done before. I'm in America. I'm British. Can you tell the accent? This is my real voice. This is my real voice. So it's different. I've never done this hugest show in America before.
A lot of niggas begging for change out in Atlanta. God damn. I walk downtown, I feel like I'm inside the goddamn inner nigga. Niggas just pop up out of no goddamn way. You don't see him walk up, you don't see him come up to you, nothing. They just appear. You just, hey, brother. Hey, how you doing? Look, I was just wondering if you just had a couple of dollars I could borrow. Maybe about $2-$3. I just wanted to get a little something. Then they give you the praying hands. Hey, brother, you just got $2 on you. If we get this something to eat, I'm a little bit hungry.
Then they try to compliment you while they get the change.
Hey, brother, you and your lady looking good right there. And look, I don't mean to disrespect you or nothing like that. If you just had any little bit of change on you to help me get me something to eat.
Atlanta was the first time I was ever on TV. Nice. Ricky Smiley was the host.
Nice.
Turned it out. You know, and then next thing I know, I started doing colleges. Then next thing I know, it's about the information. You hear the right information, you can get your foot in.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I heard Tracy Morgan was leaving Saturday Night Live. It was looking for the new black guy. I was like, shit, I'm black.
You'll be the black guy.
Yeah, let me send my
you
tape.
You black, kinda.
I'm kind of black.
Black light?
I used to be real black before I started making money.
And then
when I got in a different tax bracket, yeah. I started lightening up like a motherfucker, dude. I ain't gonna even lie, dude. My friends got
whiter. I thought
you
were Puerto Rican.
People pay to see people here. L.A., it's an entitlement of, I know so-and-so and that person, fuck that, nigga, buy the ticket. We'll hear all that bullshit. I go to McDonald's, I gotta buy a burger. I can't go in and say, well, Ronald McDonald was my friend's cousin who worked. Fuck all that. Get your ticket. Here, people like you, they coming to see you. New York, same way. Chicago, it's America City. Like, you don't get to America until you leave Los Angeles. Now you're in America. This is America right here. See people working, they enjoying the Sunday. Look at this. Look how beautiful this shit is. That's America. Do your thing, man. That's right, baby, do you. You doing a good job. See, that's America. She holding the sign. She's trying to do it. Grassroots.
Literally.
If this was Hollywood, she would have somebody with a fan, you know, a makeup team. An agent would have got her that job.
She got a little dance, too, though.
Yeah, she got a little dance. She got a little, she's working that shit. Bam. Bam. And break it down.
For me, I just want to get some black people in the seats when I go on the road because my crowds are all white. So I did the Shaq All-Star Tour. Kind of even it out a little bit, you know what I mean?
Pretty honest.
Can I be honest?
That's pretty honest.
That's pretty damn honest.
No, we're gonna cut it out, but it's fucking honest.
You just said you suck cock to get here.
That's gonna be cut out too.
This is a dollar, nigga. What you gonna do with your dollar, you gonna ball that bitch up. Really, really like this, nigga. In this type of manner, you gonna put your real money in this hand. They ain't getting this. They're getting this. So when you go in the club, what you got? We got the girl gonna be like, that nigga got money over there.
Bands will make her day.
And do this shit to her. They'll fuck them up.
All these cheeks popping, popping. I'm just popping bands. Bands will make her day. Bands will make her day.
That nigga Neo came in the club the other day, tried to outball me. This nigga coming to me like, Red Grant, what the fuck up, nigga? We about to ball so hard, that shit crazy. I'm like, okay. I go over to this nigga section, he ordered 6,000 ones. 6,000. He take 300 of the ones and throw that shit in the air and make it rain. And it rained on me. And I walked into the rain, nigga.
When you see Michael Jackson, he got the glove on. Mm-hmm. So, you know, you live that show. You know, you know Michael Jackson at home is like, yeah, man, I was outside. You know, I had these motherfuckers. You know, and he's like, oh, Michael, the camera goes, hi, the animals in the tree.
And where's that footage?
I guarantee you, Michael Jackson got a voice like mine. I'm trying to tell you, it was a show. That nigga was brilliant. He was not Looney Tunes. He was like, oh, Michael, the camera's on. Huh? My cameras are on? I just want to dance. I just want to live in the life of Michael. It's a fucking show. Cameras are off. Damn, man, what the fuck? Somebody give me some goddamn chicken wings, greens, hot sauce, cornbread.
I know Shorty ain't talking with this motherfucking City Trans outfit.
He got that bitch all on one, all the shoes, the shirt, everything was on one hanger together like a little baby outfit.
Hey man, where is your hair at, man? Have your hair, have your body outgrown your hair?
His hair
right down up under his eyeballs and shit.
Shorty look like Mike Epps on Honey, I Shrunk the Kids.
Why you take your crocodile hunter drink? Yeah, who the fuck is this? We ain't even supposed to be in this.
I know Shorty ain't talking to them Mexican Jordans.
This nigga got on.
You got on the shirt to match with this nigga jacket.
I ain't never seen no Jordans that the Jordan man got a sombrero on.
Hey, my teeth ain't bad. I need him. This nigga teeth look like Project Windows. Some of them up, some of them down. He got a little boy in one of them. I'm on punishment.
Yeah, really, this nigga look like Shaq if he got sick and shit. Got a lot of fucking weight. Look like a sick Shaq.
I shook this nigga hand and got diabetes.
Yeah, sperm bigger than you.
Hey, can we Photoshop him a neck in? Can y'all fix that in editing? I'm sorry, you're right.
Hey, let the games begin. This is what I do for a living.
Just go ahead and swallow this nigga.
All the rest of them, it's a nigga in his belly, right?
Trying to get out.
There's a nigga kicking in his belly. Oh, the nigga swallowed me.
Jones and the whale type thing.
Are you ready to start now?
That's a bullshit shirt, Finesse.
Yeah, nigga, look at
look at this candy buttons he got on this bitch.
First of all, get out of the way.
So those they are can, peppermint buttons. You
so they can see way. The first K-Swiss ever made.
Yo.
Hey, these ain't even Swiss.
Yo, hey, this for anybody just... who know about style, they gonna look at these and know
and that's not you, nigga.
this nigga jacket is made out of fabric softener. Yeah.
That nigga bought his outdoor finest.
This nigga's shoes look like skates with the wheels busted off the face.
Hey, none of them like Bruce on lap band surgery.
Red tried to laugh, so nobody.
And Robert Powell just settled his lawsuit with Eddie Long, and we just want to thank him. Confidentiality, I can't talk about that shit on the TV.
Yo, look at Red. Oh, you copping up to it?
No, Red.
Do that role you did in Lord of the Rings.
No,
take your hat off. Take your hat off and say the pressure.
I just want to say this, man. Cause somebody just wake Finesse's shoes up. His shoes asleep. You need to plug them bitches in the wall.
Please take a look
back up. His shoes on 2% right now. You need to put a new battery in them goddamn shoes.
First of all,
if I stab him, a chicken gonna fly out his goddamn belly live and peck people.